Cardulovica, Palmata, in the middle of the jungle. It's quite an effort to actually even find it. Been traveling now 1.5 hours. And you need a special knife, a special tool, and somebody that knows very well how to cut it and how to distinguish which plant should be cut and which shouldn't. It's amazing.
Well, Alberto explained that not all the branches of the plant, Cardulovica palmata, are suitable to be made into straw for the Panama hat. For example, this one is way too old. It's too mature. It's not suitable for the hat because it already has the plant open. This one would be one branch in a condition to become the straw, the toquilla straw. This is still not open, so one has to select according to the maturity of the branch. This one much too old, this one would be now in a good condition to become the straw. That's a new learning for me also. Thank you. Gracias, Alberto.
So Alberto is now cutting, he's chopping off one of the branches of the Cardulovica palmata, which is the origin of the toquilla, the straw hat, in other words, the Panama hat. He has selected the right branch. Not all of them have the right maturity to be cut, but he's an expert, he's been doing it all his life. Puede cortar. And now he chopped it. This is a very, very, very resistant branch. So this is how it has to be. It may not be open. Y aquí la abre más o así ya se la lleva. Ah, sí? So now we're gonna see how he even chops it further. He's opening it. It opens automatically. This is amazing. And now with his fingers, it's like a millefeuille, you know? It's as though it were thousands of leaves put together, and it's just so easy and so soft to open it.
Aquí como que tiene muchas hojitas, qué barbaridad, bellísimo, como si fueran hojas individuales.
So it looks as though it's made up of thousands of thin leaves, so soft and so resistant. Now Alberto has selected which leaves inside the branch are suitable or not, and he says that this is way too dark to become a nice hat, so he actually has dismissed this. He's just put it aside. He says this is useless, and he's selecting which one he can use for the hat or not. So even when he does find the right branch, it doesn't mean that within that branch you can use all the branch for a hat. You still have to select which is suitable and which is not, according to the color and according to its health condition. For example, it can be stained. And he's doing a marvelous work of selecting and de-threading the tree, palm tree, which is the prime material for the toquilla straw hat. You can see what incredible ability to de-thread it. In no time, it's become semi-straw. And he's selecting and cutting, and he has to do this with each and every branch.
Esto no vale.
Esto no vale. So this is also worthless. So he has already
he has already identified the difference between a straw, which is suitable for the hat, and a straw, which is not ideal for the hat. I'm not sure that everybody does this meticulous work, even in identifying which part of the branch is the best for the hats. Now, what's typical of Montecristi is that they're experts to identify, even here, even between the leaves within a branch, which one will make the hat as soft as linen, as resistant as anything else, more resistant than leather. This is the straw that will last forever. So this is what's going to be boiled, not this. Entonces, don Alberto, dígame, para un sombrero fino, ¿cuántas ramas así necesita? Para un fino. ¿Y uno normal? For a normal toquilla hat, you need between 25 and 30 of these pre-selected little, what can I call them, leaves. And for a better quality hat, like a super fino, fino super fino, you'd need between 30 and 40 of these. This, of course, have been already pre-selected from this, so you need an incredible amount of these leaves, and then you have to de-thread them even thinner, but you'd need about 40 then for a very nice hat, super fino. Y el super super fino, el que es así maravillosamente delgadito más. And if you want a very special hat, such as a super super fino, you'd need from 80 to 100 of these for one hat, taking into account that already selecting the branch and de-threading it and selecting this within the branch is quite an effort. Thank you. Muchas gracias, Don Alberto.
Far into the jungle, you have to go find the plant, Carculobica palmata, which constitutes the prime material for the Panama hat. It's actually even quite risky. It's quite a work. It's all an adventure to penetrate the jungle and identify the plant, because it doesn't grow just wherever. It needs this kind of environment. And you have to, of course, trust it to an expert who can identify the plant, can identify the leaves inside the plant, and then de-thread it. So we're in the middle of the Ecuadorian jungle. As you see, it's quite a labor to find the plant. We've got lots of Cardulobica palmatas here. Now remember that not all the leaves, not all the branches have the same maturity and the suitable conditions to become straw. So even if you see that many, that doesn't mean that all of them are suitable to become a hat. Maybe one or two or none out of each palm tree would be suitable for a Panama hat. So quite a special material.
Maria Ordóñez, and we're watching how the weaving is done. This family is weaving some of the finest pieces in the world. As you can see, this is an old tradition. This lady has been weaving for the past 50 years and reached the highest degree of perfection. She weaves every straw meticulously, one by one, in this position, hour by hour, day by day, week by week, month by month, until after 4 months, she's done with the weaving. It's an old tradition. It's full of passion, patience, and suffering. But very few people in the world today can weave this level of fineness. It's as though she was weaving silk, not straw. Just absolutely marvelous. This is a quality for kings and queens.